and I welcome you to this reflection for Monday of the fourth week of Lent. In today's Mass, the readings take a turn. Up until now, the daily Mass readings have been an examination of conscience for us to look at our lives and honestly come to grips where we've not been faithful to the way of Jesus. Beginning today, the Gospel reading from John will focus on Jesus as life-giver and healer. We all know what it is to be desperate in life, and today we hear a father plea for the health and life of his son. Let us listen to the fourth chapter of John's Gospel. Then Jesus returned to Cana in Galilee, where he had made the water wine. Now there was a royal official whose son was ill in Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus had arrived in Galilee from Judea, he went to him and asked him to come down and heal his son, who was near death. Jesus said to him, "Unless you people see signs and wonders, you will not believe." The royal official said to Jesus, "Sir, come down before my child dies." Jesus said, "You may go, your son will live." The man believed what Jesus said to him and left. While the man was on his way back, his slaves met him and told him that the boy would live. He asked them when he began to recover, and they told him, "The fever left him yesterday about 1 in the afternoon." And the father realized it was just at that time that Jesus said, "Your son will live." He and his whole household came to believe. Now this was the second sign Jesus did when he came to Galilee from Judea. The royal official was desperate. He was desperate for his child's life. He begs Jesus to go home with him, to heal his boy. But when Jesus told him to go home and trust in his word that his boy would live, that he would be okay, he believed. And sure enough, on his way back home, the man received word that his boy, in fact, had been healed. The point of today's gospel: the man trusted in what Jesus said. He trusted in God's word. We all know what it is to be desperate in life, when life's challenges weigh us down with anxiety and worry. At times we just don't know whom to turn to or what to trust. But today's gospel challenges us to put our unconditional trust in God's holy word. St. Paul reminded us a week ago Sunday, "The foolishness of God's word is wiser than human wisdom, and the weakness of God is stronger than human strength." And so as we go through our Lent journey, we ask, what cross, what sin, what predicament in life weighs us down with worry and anxiety? Today we are called to be like that father, that royal official, who trusted God's word. Let us pray. Father of peace, we are joyful in your word, your son Jesus Christ, who reconciles us to you. Let us hasten towards Easter with the eagerness of faith and love. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Remember, our cathedral is open every day from 6 in the morning to 7 in the evening, and Mass is celebrated daily, 7, 8:15, and 5:30. Thank you, and have a blessed day.